This tutorial is just going to run through the GUI interface to RWDecal and explain what most of the options do. So I'm going to start off RWDecal from the link on my desktop. As you can see, a GUI interface loads up. Now first of all, if you are not sure what any of the options do, you should just click the information icons to the right of most of the options, where a pop-up box will appear and explain what the option does. But we're going to run through these options now anyway. So the first option we've got is the name for your decal, which is fairly self-explanatory. Then we can have the ability, which is greyed out at the moment, but we have the ability to load settings from decals we've created in the past. So if I were to create this decal for lead station now, and then in a day or so time I wanted to change the decal slightly, maybe just do it at a lower altitude, then I could load up the settings and just change the altitude followed by clicking run, and it would just create a new decal for me. The next four boxes are the longitude and latitude for the lower left and upper right hand corner of your decals. This information is essential for creating a decal because with those two coordinates we know the area that you wish to capture. We also show you the height and the width of the area you're capturing, along with how many tiles from Google will be required and how many chunks, if we select the chunking option, which we'll explain later, how many chunks will be created. The more tiles you need and the more chunks you're creating, the longer it will take to create the decal. By far the easiest way to get coordinates into these boxes is to click the grab coordinates from Google Earth button. When we do that, Google Earth will load up and you'll have a number of buttons along the top. It will automatically go to the altitude and the position of the lower left values from the RWDecal form. So if I want to set my lower left hand marker, then we simply zoom in, and I'm happy with it there, and I get the centre of the screen roughly where I want my marker to be. Then all I do is click Set LL Place Mark, or Set Lower Left Place Mark. When we click that button, you can see the lead station LL marker appears on the screen there in the centre. Now I can zoom out and scroll up across and find my location for the upper right marker and click Set Upper Right Place Mark. Again, you can see that after doing that, we've got two markers there ready for the decal capture. If I wanted to move the upper right marker, I'd simply centre my screen on the new location and click Set Upper Right Marker again. And as you can see, it's jumped across there. Once we know we've got the locations correct, we need to grab those into RWDecal. So we do that by clicking the Grab Lower Left Place Mark buttons. And when it's finished, we'll get a little information warning. And then we can do the same again for the upper right option. Once we've done that, you can see from the form that we've updated the settings with those coordinates that we've just selected there. There is a cautionary note that I need to let you know. You should not move these decals, these markers rather, by right-clicking and going Properties. Once you do that, you can drag the marker around, but as I say, you should not do this. The reason for this is if you look at the latitude and longitude here, they're changing as I move the marker about, which is as you'd expect. However, there's another tab here called the View. And as we move that marker about, although the top of the settings are changing, the view settings are not changing. Now, the view settings are where the camera will fly to when you double-click the marker in Google Earth, or when you click the Grab or Go to Place Mark options in RWDecal. So if we move the marker to a new location and the view options don't change, what will happen is that when you fly to the marker, you'll think you're capturing where the yellow pointer is, but you'll actually be capturing from the original location for when you created the marker. So, if you want to create to move a marker, you should use the Set UR Place Mark buttons or Set LL Place Mark. Just to give you a final example of this, we'll move this to a new location and click OK. Now when I click to go lower left place mark, you can see it doesn't move to the lead station lower left, it moves to its original location. However, if I just go Set Lower Left Place Mark, you can see it updates and we now got it all back aligned again. So the next option is the altitude, which is fairly self-explanatory. If you're running an unlicensed version of RWDecal, then you can use all the form settings are exactly the same. However, if you go below 1,000 meters, then the bottom half of the decal will be rendered in black. You will still be able to see what the RWDecal can do for you, but you won't be able to obviously get the whole decal. To get a license, you simply need to visit www.rwdecal.co.uk and make a donation of at least £1. Once you've done this, you'll receive a license via email, and this will give you access to all the altitudes without the lower half being turned to black. However, you can create decals above 1,000 metres with all the information there that you require, so it's still a tool completely free that you can use. The lower the altitude that we use, the more details we'll be receiving in the decal, and you can go right down to 25 metres or right up to 5,000 metres. The next option is the decal method. Now, if we do a large area, RWDecal will recommend that you chunk that decal up into smaller blocks. This is because of an issue in railworks where large decals, when you place them on uneven terrain, can have sections that vanish and become invisible. If you chunk the decals up, this is much less likely to happen. You have three options: chunks, full, and chunks and full. Then we've got the camera speed. If you just want to get the decal created as quickly as possible, you should select instant, and the camera will hop around Google Earth, instantly capturing the images. Then we've got the advanced options. The due north fix is therefore it will apply a rotation to the decal to improve the decal to marker alignment. There's an issue with railworks and how it interprets longitude and latitude, which results in decals being rotated. Where if you try and line them up, you have to rotate them to make them align properly. To save you having to do this for every decal inside railworks, once you know what degree rotation you require, you can just enable this option and enter it on the in the box there, and then the decal will be automatically rotated for you, and hopefully, fingers crossed, it'll align pretty accurately straight away. If you're making a route in the UK, you can use the UK route option, which will estimate the degrees of rotation that you require. We're hoping to give you more options in the future, but for the moment we can only give an estimate, and I stress it is an estimate, for the degrees of rotation in the UK. The create markers option, as you know, RailWorks has markers in it, so you can create flag markers, and they use a special customised RWDecal flag that helps you align markers more easily. And you can create these flags for the corners of the full decal, the centre of the full decal, or both, and the same for each individual chunk. Finally, we can automatically export the decal, so once it's been created, RWDecal creates the blueprints, and if you enable this option, these blueprints will be exported straight to RailWorks, so you don't even have to go into Blueprint Editor and export them. And the last option, which is only available if you do select the automatic export option, is to delete the blueprints, ACE and CSV files needed to create the markers after you've exported them, because once you've exported them, you don't need these files anymore. We'll quickly go through the file and preferences menu. In the file menu, we can obviously quit, we can recalibrate Google Earth. We also have the ability to delete the files from the RWDecal creates in the source folders and the assets folder or export bit folders. In preferences, there are lots of options and I won't go through them all, but the key ones are the set program folder locations, where we can reconfigure any of the original paths. We can turn debugging on, we can change the capture area. This can prevent you getting the navigation system appearing in your decals from Google Earth, so we can reduce that to make sure we don't capture that part of the Google Earth window. We can choose a decal quality, which can improve performance if you set a lower value, but obviously you lose out on quality. The other key options are the disabling of Google Earth layers and the disabling of Google Earth places before we do a decal creation. If we don't disable these options, then whatever you see in Google Earth will be captured into your decal. So this can be an advantage if you want to capture roads and different layers from Google Earth, but obviously it can be a disadvantage if you've left these options on. You could end up with yellow markers and place marks appearing in your decal. In the help option, we've got the ability to request a license and enter our license details, and we've got the ability to check whether RWDecal is running the latest version or not. We can also access the PDF manual, and there's a link to the online support. That's the end of this tutorial.